Today we will see what is third law of motion. Everybody is aware or knows about this law, that by the statement of this law is very common and everybody knows this statement. It says that to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. But in terms of physics, we have something related to forces. So here, action is a kind of a force and reaction is also a force. So whenever one object exerts force on the second object, that is called as action. And the object on which the first object exerts the force, the second object also exerts the force on the first object, and that is called as reaction. And students, action and reaction are exactly equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So friends, whenever if you throw a ball on the wall, ball moving towards the wall and hitting the wall is an action, and ball bouncing from the wall is a reaction. So if you throw the ball with 5 N of force on the wall also pushes the ball towards us with 5 N of force. And it is observed, it's very clear that when you throw the ball towards the wall also throws back the ball towards us, throws back, or it opposes by pushing it towards us. But we don't see it actually pushing it, but we can see, we can understand that by when the ball comes to us. Let us take some other example. If you're standing on a, for example, wearing a skateboard, and if you push the ball, the person who is pushing the ball moves backwards. So action is in the forward direction on the ball, and the reaction is the backward direction. There are various examples of third law of motion. Like, for example, it is because of the third law that we are able to walk. It is because of the third law. Suppose when we are walking, we exert force in the backward direction, and the ground exerts the reaction on our feet in the forward direction. Once again, when we are walking, we exert the force in the backward direction, so that is an action, and the ground exerts the force on our feet in the opposite direction, that is why we move forward. There are many other examples. For example, when you fire a bullet from the gun, the motion of the bullet in the forward direction is action, and the motion of the gun, a recoil of the gun in the backward direction, is a reaction. Let us take one more example. Suppose if you are alighting from a boat near the bank, suppose there is a boat and you are going to alight from it, alight means if you are trying to come out of the boat, you move forward and the boat moves backward. So when we move forward, it is a action, and the reaction, because of the reaction, the boat moves backwards. There are many other examples, like an example of a rocket. When rocket moves up, it exerts the force on the rocket in the upward direction. That is action, and the motion of the gases down is the reaction. So my friends, action is a force, reaction is also force, and action and reaction, they are exactly equal, but the direction is exactly opposite. So the negative sign tells us that the direction of action and reaction is opposite, whereas the equal sign says that they are equal in magnitude. Thank you.